स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू वर्चुअल क्लास ऑफ म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ ग्रेटर मुंबई एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट. आई एम मिसेस अक्षता काले एंड टुडे वी विल लर्न मैथ्स. कम ऑन स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस मूव टू द चैप्टर.
एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द मैथ्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 5th, द फर्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज रोमन न्यूमरल्स. Students, please observe this carefully. Here we can see two wall clocks, right? Here the first wall clock has the international numerals, that is 1 to 12, and in the second wall clock we can see the Roman numerals, that is also from 1 to 12. Yes students, international numerals you know nicely. Today we are going to learn about the Roman numerals. Okay, now Roman numerals, why the name Roman numerals? You will see that in Europe in the old times Roman capital letters were used to write numbers. That is why they were called Roman numerals. Okay? Now, they used some symbols to write the numerals. We will see them first. 1 means here, they used to write capital I. For 5, they used capital V, and for 10 they use capital X. Remember this, 1 means I, 5 means V, and 10 means X. These symbols you keep in your mind, then we will go through some of the rules. Students, we fix rules to play the games. Right? Without rules, we don't play the games. Like that also here, some rules we have to follow while writing Roman numerals. There are 4 rules. We will go through one by one. Number one, rule number one is, if either of the symbols I or X is written consecutively 2 or 3 times, the sum total is the number they make. Means if we write 1 twice, then the value of this is 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. Got this? Some more example we will see. Now 1 I will write thrice, 3 times. Means the value is 1 plus 1 plus 1. So the sum is 3. Right, one more we will take. 2 times X is nothing but 10 plus 10, that is equal to 20. Got this? Means if we write the same number consecutively, then we add and we will get the total value of that number. Okay, we will move to rule number 2. See, this is rule number 2. Here the symbol I or X can be written consecutively for a maximum of 3 times. The numeral V is never repeated consecutively. We'll see here I 3 times means the value is 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is 3, you know. Means we can write this maximum 3 times, not more than that. Okay, you can use that one 1 time, or in 2 times you can use, or 3 times. Maximum is thrice you can use the same number. Now here also, X also we can write 3 times. That is the maximum. Okay, see here, 10 plus 10 plus 10 means is equal to 30. Okay, what about V? That is 5 number. What is said in the rule? We can use 5 only once. We cannot repeat that. Okay, means twice, thrice, we can't use that one. Only one time we can write 5. Remember this. This is all about the rule number 2. Now we will move to rule number 3. The rule number 3 says that when either I or V is written on the right of the symbol of a bigger number, its value is added to the value of the bigger number. See, we will write V. This is a bigger number and I have written I on the right side of the V. Okay, right side. So, we are going to add 1 to 5. See, 5 plus 1 is 6. The value of I, V is nothing but 6. One more we will take. X is 10 and we are writing I to the right of that one. So, we are going to add 1 to 10. So, the answer is 11. One more we will take. X and right side I am writing here V. So, we are going to add 5 to 10. So, that the answer is 15. One more we will take. See here 3. 3 numbers we have taken. V and I are written on the right side of the X. So, here the value is 10 plus 5 plus 1. So, is equal to 16. Got this? When you write I or V on the right side of a bigger number, we add the numbers. Now, we'll move to rule number 4. Now, when we write to the left of a bigger number, that I or X, we have to subtract the number. Okay? And we can use I or X to the right only once. Sorry, to the left only once. See here. I'm writing I to the left of this one. So, I'm going to minus 1 from 5. See. The value is 4. Got this? Take one more. I, we are writing on the left of X. So, we are going to subtract 1 from 10. So, the value is 9. Remember this. Take here. See. X, I, V. Only you take I and V. Because X we know that is 10. And I, V means up you can see that is nothing but 4. So, here we will 10 plus 4 we will do. Okay, this is 4 you know. So, the value is 14. Like this we write 14. 14 means X, I, V. I, V is nothing but 4. One more. Yes, I know that you know the value of this one. X is 10, then IX means that is nothing but, correct, 9 that is. So, the answer is 19. Got this children? These are the 4 important rules we have to follow while writing Roman numerals. Okay. Now students, this is from your textbook. We will see that whether they are right or they are wrong. If it is right, we will put right mark in the box and if it is wrong, we will put cross mark. See, observe the first one. The first column, first row shows the international numerals and second row shows the Roman numerals. Okay, see first one 4. How it is written? I 4 times. Is that right? No, that is wrong because what the second rule says? Second rule says that we can use I maximum 3 times, not 4 times. So, we are going to use the fourth rule to write that. That is I, V. We are writing I on the left side of the V. So, we are going to minus 1 from 5. that is nothing but 4. Correct? Okay, we'll move to second column. 6 means VI. Yes, dear students, according to third rule, this is correct. Now we'll move to third column, that is 8. IIX. Yes, you know that this is wrong one, because only one time we can write I to the left of a bigger number according to rule number 3. Sorry, according to rule number 4, correct? So this is wrong. How we will write 8? See, like this, because V is nothing but 5 and 1 means I, we can write 3 times. So 5, 6, 7, 8, that is 8. Okay, what about 16? X and 6. Very good. This is right. And what about 15? The last one. V, V, V. Again, this is wrong. Right? This is wrong. Because the second rule says that we cannot use V thrice or twice. We can write only one time. So, how we will write 50? 10 and 5, that is 15. Got this? Okay. Now students, remember this. In this method, there was no symbol for 0. Also, the value of a symbol did not change with its place. You know that the value changes according to the place value, right? In third, fourth, we studied that one. But here, the value did not change according to its place. Now students, some more symbols we will learn today. This you know, 1 is I, 5 means V, 10 means X. This we know. And we studied the rules also, depending on this. Now this is some more we will learn here. 50 means L, 100 means C, 500 we write as D, and 1000 we write as M. See here, 4 new introduced. 50 we write as L, C means 100, D means 500, and M means 1000. Remember this, we use only capital alphabets. Okay, now we will move. Here one table is there, then now we will practice to write these numbers in Romans. Okay, first one 20, this is very easy, you know that. 10 plus 10, that is 20, this is right. 45, how we will write 45? 40 means here we will write 50 plus, 50 means L. Then we will minus 10. So I am writing X to the left hand side. So it became 40. And 5, you know the symbol V. We will write to the right side. Okay, so it is 45. Then what about 73? Yes, students, you are right. 50 we will write first. Then this is 60. Plus 10, this is 70. And 3 means 1. 1 and 1, because we can write 3 times. See, this is 50 plus 10 plus 10, that is 70 plus 3. Got this? How to write, you came to know? 21 is that easy. 59, again 50 we will write first, and then 9. 9 also you know how to write. Then 99. Yes, 100 we will write first, then to the left we will write 10, then it became 90, and this side we will write 9. Okay, got this? Now 38, 38, very easy, so I have written directly. Now we'll move to 44, again 50 we will take first, then we will minus 10, then it became 40. Then we will write 4 to the right side. 83, 50, 3 times x, then 3 times 3. Very easy. Okay, 100. Yes, you know the symbol for 100. That is capital C. Then 56. 50 and 6. 34. 3 times x and 4. 96 means 90. Again, first we will write C means that is 100. Minus 10, it became 90. And here 6 to the right. Then 50, that is nothing but capital L. Yes, dear students, I hope that you came to know all this. Right? Please practice the same. You only take the other numbers and try to write in Roman numerals. Okay?
Thank you very much for being a part of this lesson. Please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get the new updated videos.